I'm back. Sorry, I haven't made a video in a while, but I've been kind of bleh and not really fit for camera. But I'm back, and I feel like I should do a video today. So, I'm gonna do one. And I just checked my YouTube, and holy crap, only 12 subscribers, which is like, I can't believe 12 people want to hear me talk to a camera. That's amazing. I know people have like thousands upon thousands of subscribers, but I mean, like, and obviously more is good, but 12 is great. So to the 12 people who subscribe to me, thank you very much. It gives me the warm fuzzies. So I'm making this video because, I got a comment from a guy, or at least I think it's a guy, called, named JustinN86, who, watched my 50 Shades videos. By the way, good taste, awesomeness. Okay, I got a couple comments about those videos, but I should say three, because a couple was two. So I got like three comments about those videos, two of which were from dudes, which was kind of weird. Well, not weird, I shouldn't say that. It was unexpected, I think is a better word. Unexpected that men would read this novel. So, but that's great that they did, or at least want to know about it if they haven't read it. That's awesome. And to you two gentlemen, thank you very much. And there was one girl who said, she wouldn't read it because it sounded too disturbing. Which, I mean, okay, it's not everybody's cup of tea. But, yeah, I'm getting comments from people I don't know. So that's great, and 12 people want to hear me talk. So that's great, so here I am talking. Anyway, I'm doing this video because JustinN86 wanted me to talk about The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo, or as I guess it's called, the Millennium series. Now, I will do a proper movie review because I've seen the movie. I've not read the books, but I've seen the movie. And, I would watch it again to do a review, but that movie scared the crap out of me. Scared is the wrong word. See, this is what happens when I don't write a script. I just shoot my mouth off on these videos. But apparently 12 people think that's okay. So, that's awesome. But anyway, yeah, I saw that movie in theaters because my family had read the books and wanted to go to the movie, and I asked my dad, because I remember watching the trailer and thinking, I'm not gonna like this movie, but then I asked my dad when he said, hey, we're all, or maybe it was my mom, somebody said, hey, we're all gonna go to the Dragon Tattoo, and the girl with the Dragon Tattoo, do you wanna go? And I'm like, well, Daniel Craig is kind of cool, and, sure, but first, what disturbed me or what scared me? And my dad said, no, you'll be fine. And my mom said, don't go, and scare the crap out of you. And, disturb you and you won't like it. My sister, said that I probably wouldn't like it, but if I needed it older and if I got scared, that's okay. And I'm like, okay, well, I'll go, because everybody's going, and I'd be in the house by myself, but, so I'll just go. So I went, and, I should've stayed the fuck home. I so should've. It's not that it wasn't a well-done movie, because it was. I mean, I haven't read the book, like I said, so I don't know if it was very true to the novel. I can't speak for that. But as a movie, for what it was okay. It just, like, so totally was not my cup of tea. I remember sitting in the theater and the entire time just thinking, I should have stayed home. I should have stayed home. Holy crap, I should have stayed home and written my fan fiction and just stayed home. oh my god, why didn't I jump? And that was what was entirely going through my head the whole time. And, like I said, it was a good movie. Like, the acting was good, or at least I thought the acting was good. And the, it had Christopher Plummer from The Sound of Music in it, which was awesome. It was weird seeing him as an old guy, though. But I guess people age. But in my head, he will always be Captain Von Trapp, I'm sorry. But, so seeing like Captain Von Trapp old is, like, weird. But, yeah. But, for those of you who don't know The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo was about, it had several stories. One was about I think he was a detective, although he might have been a writer. See, I haven't watched it in a while, and I'm not watching it because it scared the crap out of me. But I think it was a writer who Christopher Plummer hired as a detective, to find out what happened to. It was either his daughter or his niece. I can't remember. But, anyway, yeah, he's on this hunt to find who hurt this girl. And well on the, and then there's a second story about this girl who I can't remember her name. And she is the girl with the dragon tattoo. And she has a really, really sucky life and is kind of a delinquent. And then, you know, I remember very clearly, it was like her parole officer or something. Sexually assaults her, which, oh my god, so disturbing. That's when I thought, oh my god, I should tell him, oh my god. She gets him back, like, and carves into his chest that he's, like, a pervert, which, in one way, I thought was awesome, because, you know, the guy's a complete monster and an animal and deserves to be punished to the nth degree, but, then I didn't like it because they actually show it. It's not like, hey, I'm here and I'm going to do evil stuff to you. Cut away, here's the evil stuff I did to you. No, they like show everything. And there's like stuff, I can't even remember. She's like carving things into his chest and there's butt plugs at one point, which my mom, for some reason, likes to keep bringing up as a joke sometimes. I don't understand. Yeah, she already told me that she went to Girl with the Dragon Tattoo with me, but she's never doing anything like that again, so I can do go to 50 Shades myself when it comes out, which is okay. I wouldn't want to go with my mom anyway. That would be so weird. Yeah. So, from what I remember, I just remember being very scared, like, fucking terrified, and thinking it was a really well-done movie to get across what it wanted to get across, which was, hey, this is fucking terrifying, and look how horrible this girl's life is, and you should be disturbed. Like, yeah. In that way, it's good. It truly shows you how horrible and detestable this girl's life is. And that we should feel sorry for her and sort of weep for her. Like, it's all done really well. It's just, not my cup of tea at all. At all. And oh my god, there was one point where Daniel Craig's in a basement and he's like tied up or some shit and Buddy's like cutting him and it's gross. And there's like torture, and I just remember thinking, why didn't I stay home and write my Spike and Buffy wedding scene for my fan fiction? Why didn't I do that? I could like be fake picking out orchids right now, but no, I'm sitting here watching this crap and probably scarring me for life. So yeah, very well done movie. Very well done. Truly makes you feel sorry for the characters, and you do feel connected to the characters. If it wasn't so disturbing, I might actually liked it. But, yeah. That's my thoughts on The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo. very disturbing. If you can't handle graphic violence or graphic sort of disturbing shit, don't go see it because it'll scar you for life. I'm getting out of the theater and turning to my mother and going, okay, well now we're going to go to Beauty and the Beast. Because I need something to cleanse my head of that. So, and I know what people are going to say, like, movies, you know, are supposed to sometimes represent life, and life isn't always pretty. And I agree with that. And it's like, totally make movies like that. Yes, the world is gross. And full of gross people who do disturbing, disgusting things. But, I just don't want to watch it. And I wish I hadn't. But then if I hadn't, I wouldn't be doing this video right now. And responding to your request. So, yeah, that's pretty sweet. So I guess I got that out of it. Because this video is so short, I'm going to talk about a couple other things very, very, very quickly. I don't know when my next video is going to be up. I don't even know what it's going to be about yet. And really, this video thing is just a hobby. I'm not trying to get all, like, famous and stuff. I have other ways that I'm trying to get semi-famous, which, shameless plug time, I will have a book coming out. It's all written, and it's all ready to be put up on Smashwords. But I don't have a book cover yet, and I'm trying to get that organized, and holy crap, like, things are just, sometimes I wish things just aren't falling into place for me with this thing. They just really aren't. Like, I'm getting further and further that, than I ever thought I would. So really, I shouldn't be complaining. But, yeah, it's just very frustrating to be so close and then not have that last little bit sort of fall in place. So, yeah, that's frustrating. But it's an awesome book, and it'll be awesome when it comes out. Yeah, super sweet. Super sweet. And I'll keep you guys posted on that. I also have a blog that I'm posting on. No, I wouldn't say on a regular basis, but more regular than I'm doing this. At the moment, anyway. And, I just did a blog about the Buffy the Vampire Slayer movie, which was awful. The show is great. I love the show. If you've seen any of the other videos on my channel, you'll know that Spike is my baby, and I love him. And the show is great, and I think it's genius, and oh my god, they should win awards for being the best TV show of all time. But the movie sucked so bad and hurt my head, and it was terrible. So if you want to learn more about my horrendous experience with that film, I will post the blog in the description at the bottom down there of this down there. You should go click it because it's funny. So yeah, there's that. Speaking of Buffy, I'll be doing I'm going to Comic-Con in Montreal with my friend and my folks in September. Thanks for that, by the way, Mom and Dad. That's awesome that you're doing that. And I love your faces, and that's like the best thing of all time, and you're awesome. And anyway, yeah, I'll be going to that in, depending on when we leave, I want to say 44 days. Because, I mean, it's going to take us a day or two to get down there, because we're driving, and, yeah, I don't live in Quebec, so. I'm sorry if that cut out, but, somebody just walked in my room, so that's why I had to stop. But they're gone now, so we can continue. I'd like to apologize for my voice, in the first part of this video. I had no idea I was so mumbly. Oh my god, and I would record it again, but then I'd lose everything I said, and because I don't script these, then it will just turn into shit. So, I'm sorry about that, and this part I will try to do better, even though it's shorter, because I'm going to finish up, unless I start rambling again, which I sometimes do. So, yeah, I apologize for my voice, and I apologize if that cut out. But anyway, here we go. Yeah, I'll be going to Copacabana with my folks and my best friend in September. And James Rogers and Nicholas Brennan and Sam's... I think it's Huntington. Yeah, Sam Huntington and the from Being Human, which I started watching, and it's awesome. And, I can't remember her name. Her voice, Sally the Ghost, in that, and I'm talking about the U.S. version, not the U.K. version. I did try to watch the U.K. version first, because I'm like, hey, but I didn't really like it. I like this one much better. I could actually do a video about the first season of Being Human when I finish watching it. I've got about 5 episodes left, I think. So, yeah, I'll probably finish that and do a vlog or blog about that. Maybe both, if I'm feeling ambitious. Yeah, so sorry for all the name dropping, but I'll be going to that, and it's going to be awesome. And I'm going to be meeting all those people and stuff, and going to panels and stuff, and my friend has agreed to help me videotape some of it so I can put some of my experience up here on YouTube for you guys to have vicariously through me, through a video diary of my experience. So that's awesome, and thank you for doing that. You know who I'm talking to, so thank you for doing that, honey. That's great. And you're fabulous. Yeah. And I'll be going to that, and so there'll definitely be a video diary about that. I'm not sure how long it's going to be. I'm not sure what I'm going to videotape and what I'm not going to videotape. I know I probably won't videotape panels, because I don't want to get caught, and it's stupid. But probably when I meet everybody and be like running around freaking out because it's full of famous people and the Batmobile and things, there'll definitely be a video of me and my friend on the floor. And maybe my parents, if I can convince them to be in my video vlog. So that would be awesome. And, yeah, I don't know what's going to be in that, but I can guarantee it's going to be epic and fabulous. So there's that. And that's my big, the only video I have planned right now. But that's, like, a month and a bit away right now. So, I'll probably do a video before then. I'm just not sure on what. Probably Being Human. I have blogs planned out. If you go to my blog and subscribe and comment, on the blog, I'd love your faces. I think I prefer doing the blogs because... it gives me more time to map things out. This video vlog is only when I'm lazy and don't feel like writing shit down. Or want to get it out, like, right away, my first impressions. That's why I get, I do a lot of movie reviews on here. It's because I want to get my first impression when I see a movie. And I want to get it out, like, hours after I've seen it. And with the blog, you know, you write a little bit, and then you get tired, and then you come back. Because blogs are a lot of thinking. Like, I did that blog about the Buffy film yesterday. And, after watching it, because I sat and watched it, because my friend said it was good. Shame on you. Shame. Yeah, I wrote it, and I started writing it, and then I got tired, And then I wrote it all day yesterday and put the photos in and found all the photos and put them in and wrote all the captions in the right spot and things. And by the time I edited it and did all that, it was like 12:30 at night. I guess in the morning, depending on your definition. By the time I actually got it up, yeah, it was like midnight, or no, like 12:30. Yeah, so that's up. Yeah, I like doing the blogs better because it gives me time to map it out. Unless I want to get something out right away, or I feel like there's too much for me to type and I'm lazy, like with those 50 Shades videos. But if you watch them, which you should, because they, even though they're kind of sloppy, I think I make some good points. But then again, I may be biased. I had too much to say to write down, and it would have been like a 50-page vlog, or blog, and I didn't want to do that. So that's why I did the blog. I also like the blog, yeah, just because they're easier, and they're faster, and, you know. But I think I'm going to get back into blogging, because I seem to get more hits on that. Not that I'm going to abandon this, because I'm not. It's just, if you want more of me, subscribe to the blog, because you'll probably get me more often than you will on here, although you won't be able to see my pretty face, so that's sad. But you still get me just on paper instead of my voice. Yeah, so I guess that's about it. If you guys have a video you want me to do on anything, like my experience with writing and stuff, if you guys are interested in what it was like to write a novel or what it's like to have a disability, although I have a second channel for that, but I do that with a friend, and she hasn't really been into it lately, but it's called Disability Debunked. I will see if I can find the video and put it in the description so you guys can watch that as well and subscribe to that, because that's also a good channel. But if you have questions about what it's like to live with a disability, or what it's like just to be a 21-year-old girl living in the city, or what I like or what I don't, or my opinions on anything, I will answer anything. I'm an open book. I really have nothing to hide. So that's awesome. Yeah, thank you for watching. If you watch this whole thing, because holy crap, it's like almost a half an hour long now. See, this is what I do when I don't have a blog and I rant. I just go till I'm finished. And it takes a long time. But, yeah. I'm sorry, I'm staring at Spike instead of the camera. That's why I'm going like this. I'm staring at Spike. He is above my desk. It is wonderful. Yeah, any comments or questions or reviews or books you think I should read to review, totally okay. And I'll do that, because the fact that 12 people want to hear me talk is awesome. Thank you very much. And I will see you whenever I see you. Peace out.